he a winner?
Well, he owns things.
Is that what makes a winner?
Well, what else does?
Does it bother you what he said?
Yeah. Yeah, it bothers me a lot. As you see twice, Sarah. Once at Ames with Minnesota Fats. And then again at Arthur's.
And in that cheap, crummy pool room. Now, why'd I do it, Sarah? Why'd I do it? I could have beat that guy. I could have beat him cold. He never would have known. I just had to show him. Just had to show those creeps and those punks what the game is like when it's great, when it's really great. You know, like anything can be great. Anything can be great. I don't care if bricklaying can be great if a guy knows. If he knows what he's doing and why, and if he can make it come off. Like, well, I'm going. I mean, when I'm really going, I feel like a jockey must feel. He's sitting on his horse. He's got all that speed and that power underneath him. He's coming into the stretch. The pressure's on him. And he knows. He just feels when to let it go and how much. Because he's got everything working for him. Timing, touch. It's a great feeling, boy. It's a real great feeling when you're right and you know you're right. It's like all of a sudden I got oil in my arm. Pool cue's part of me. You know, it's a pool cue. It's got nerves in it. It's a piece of wood. It's got nerves in it. You feel a roll of those balls. You don't have to look. You just know. You make shots that nobody's ever made before. And you play that game the way nobody's ever played it before.
You're not a loser, Eddie. You're a winner. Some men never get to feel that way about anything. I love you, Eddie.